Hey YouTubers, Grimmy Dragon here, and it's time for another Grim Customs, and yeah, we're going to be making a custom circuit breaker figure. This is the figure we're going to be using as our base, and that is the Boss Fight Studio Vitruvian Hacks customizable figure in champagne beige. So, and we're going to be making this into Circuit Breaker from Transformers. And I'm just pulling up a picture so I have a reference. Yeah. So, yeah, this is going to be a pretty cool figure. Pardon me if I sneeze every now and then. Allergies can be like that, but in any case, yeah, this is good. I'm working with a couple cameras. You can see the tripod in one of them, and yeah, you actually can see the tripod from both, from one to the other on either screen, so this is going to be pretty cool. Hopefully this will work out well, but having multiple angles to work with will help me in the end. So, yeah, we're going to start off with the head. Actually going to just pop the head off the body for now. So we can actually do the work on the eyes and the mouth. So, starting off, I'm going to just take this little needle. See if I can get it better focus. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, one camera has a focus on it. So got that needle. Just lightly dab it in. And this is tricky, so. But it is going to be worthwhile. If I could get the paint to actually flow right. Unfortunately, my hand's a little shakier than I'd like. So, just trying to. But we can get this to go into the eye area. And yeah, for those who complain about the derp eyes, that a lot of companies have been doing lately, like Matty and Hasbro, I gotta tell you, eyes are tricky, especially with these really small figures. Because you gotta get it in there just right. And honestly, that's kind of hard to do. It's smearing all around the eye area. I'm going to have to try to remove some. Because, yeah, this kind of looks a little messy. My camera doesn't want to quite focus on the thing. Let me see if I can just adjust the focus a little bit. There we go. As you can see, she kind of looks like she's got bug eyes because I put a little too much on there. It doesn't look horrible, but yeah, it's not perfect. But it's something I'm probably going to have to work at this a little more. Just to get it right. And you know how white paint is, it's always a pain in the butt to deal with. Just want to go over with my nails, see if I can just to tighten up just a tad. One eye just doesn't look right. Let's just see if we can. Okay, that will have to do. It looks fine from a distance. So go in some terpenoid, and I know I forgot a paper towel. So I'm gonna cut now and come back. Okay, yeah, I'm back. I got a paper towel. Be very helpful with cleaning off the brush, like the needle that I'm using for this. Because I'm going to need it again for the lips. And yeah, I'm going to put actual irises in. I just want to wait for that paint to dry a bit. Hopefully. Oh boy, just trying to get something to go, and I dropped the blasted head. And we'll have a couple more tries to get that right too with the eyes, because we've got a few more heads here. So, like, I was actually practicing with this one. So yeah, you can see that one had some work done. I think the eyes came out a little better on that one too. I might be wrong. But so it's a shame because this one that I'm working with here is actually going to be the main head. But we're going to add some lipstick to her mouth. Hopefully I can get this right and not make it look sloppy. Again, people who do this for a living have their work cut out for them. Okay, and that actually turned out very nice. So that part's done. And we're going to come back to this a little later to work on the hair. Because I want that to dry a bit. And we'll probably be working on another head later on. I just wanted to get the main head kind of addressed, at least. Because that's the one I want to work with the most, because it Circuit Breaker's kind of a short hair character. Might do the long hair one a little later. So, yeah. But it's time to actually work with the body. Now, there are parts I can take apart for this body if I wanted to, but given the how intricate the actual body is, like the actual circuit tape is on this character, I'm probably going to just keep it on and try to work with it in one go, which might not be easy, but we'll see what we can do. So we got our chrome silver. And we got this little brush here. So we're going to get to work. This is a micro brush, super fine. So this one should be good for doing 3 3/4 inch figures. And yeah, we're going to start by covering some of the more important things to cover. Like the chest, and yeah, we're getting some thunder here. I'm just going to cover this up with the silver. And hopefully you guys can see what I'm doing. There we go. And yeah. Yeah, you gotta get the. This will at least make sure she's not naked through the whole thing. Yeah. But. Yeah, have any of you guys got some of the Vitruvian Hacks figures yet? Or is this the first time seeing one? I do have a review going for this particular blank body. Should be out by now. If not, it will be out very soon. Obviously, it's not out at the time of the recording, but, you know, just got this last Friday, so. Yeah, I got the chest done. Just going to get over to the crotch just to make sure no one gets upset over a naked woman. I guess a woman with body paint will be fine for them, though. And hopefully this won't come out as dull. The real hard part is actually just keeping my hand steady while I'm trying to paint this. Yeah, that done. Maybe we'll just make it a gauge string. For now, you know, at least. It's the unfortunate thing. It's hard to find rear shots of comic characters when they're not very actively used. And unfortunately, since Circuit Breaker is only in the Transformers comics, Marvel comics, except for one Secret Wars issue that came out before the Transformers issue, just to keep her with Marvel. Now, this is quite the obscure character. Which is a shame, because, you know, I've only seen one issue of Marvel with her, but I thought it was pretty good. I thought she was a cool character. Okay, so we got the basic coverings done. So now we can get a little more intricate here. And yeah, she is actually intricate. And this is going to be tricky, because I gotta do a lot of straight lines. It might go wrong, but yeah, trying to get that circuit pattern on her body is not easy. We got that started. And yeah, it does seem like I might be ignoring one camera for the other. Kind of hard to do two at once, it seems. But I'll keep trying. Yeah, I'm just trying to get that shoulder. And if I have to remove a piece to get it going, I will, but just gonna start with just keeping it together. Yeah, we're just gonna cover this one shoulder up with silver. Kind of the way that the character is at least showing herself on here. I'm looking at probably one of the best shots that I got of her, an introductory shot from issue 9 of the Transformers Marvel series, which is way old. Came out in the 80s, but yeah. Still a really good comic. Okay, so we got that shoulder done. And it is starting to come along nicely. So, yeah. Yeah, this is not easy though. But, yeah, Circuit Breaker herself, well, probably not my favorite character. I really do like the concept of having a human who had electrical powers that could fight the robots, didn't really care for them much. So, as a concept, Circuit Breaker was pretty cool. And that's maybe a little bit too much. But, yeah, it's coming along. I had to ease up on that part. I mean, I think she would have been a little more interesting a character in the Transformers series if they let her be in it after Marvel Comics. But, you know, it is what it is. And yeah, this isn't going to be the straightest lines. Unfortunately, I don't have a steady hand here. But we're going to try to get this as good as we can. Yeah, the only problem is I just don't have any references for the back area. So I'm going to have to completely wing it from there. Which is not going to be easy. I'm just trying to start with the front body, see if I can get that to go. And so far, so good. Now we're just going to work at this arm that we started on earlier. Get that going. Yeah. Yeah. She kind of looks like she has a wristband at this point. So I'm just gonna around it. Since she does have silver on her hands as well, oops, I'm going to have silver on my hands too at this rate. I can just put a little bit on the back of her hand. There we go. One arm is coming along nicely. Yeah. At least this is coming along well. Just hopefully I won't have to, I won't make cuts in a bad spot. Okay, that's one arm hopefully done. May not be perfect, but it's something. This one's going to be a little different. So we'll start with the inner part of the arm. And the outer. This one just seems to have a like a bit of a circle on the edge of it. So see if we can get that to work to our advantage. Yeah, so just trying to get this right. It's tricky. So just painting a little bit on the right on the wrists. Seem to have a kind of a rib cage bit that goes in there. Let's see. Add a little bit more. Details here. There we go. Yeah, this is coming along nicer than I thought it would. Unfortunately, I'm not a world-class customizer or anything, but, you know, just trying to do something nice. And it's fun to, you know, paint for you guys. I hope you guys enjoy it. Yeah, we got the arms done, and that camera, I just can't use autofocus with it for some reason. There we go. Much better. As you can see, coming along nicely. I've already got silver on her legs before I even get to them. But we'll get that done now. Because I actually have something to work with on that for reference. So we're going to just work with this thigh first. At least one of her knees is going to be silver. I'm doing a little bit of a artistic addition, just because the way this thing came out. Oh boy, sounds like we're gonna get a storm tonight. Boy. Just trying to get that pattern in right. Seems I'm going to be using one camera more than the other. Which is unfortunate, but, you know, I'm still kind of figuring this kind of thing out. Another unfortunate thing is that it seems like the patterns are a little bit more tricky to get down than I thought they would be. Kind of improvising some. Not to mention the shape of the leg is kind of messing with me too. Yeah, that leg is coming along nice. Get a little more of a circuit on the back of the leg. There we go. Okay, now that we're on to the feet. Oh, we're up to 1 foot. Hold off on that for a bit while I work on the other leg. Boy, this is not easy to do. Probably said that a few dozen times, but and like I said, some of this is going to be kind of improvised. Because this leg in particular has a really intricate design. I on it, but try to replicate it as best as I can. If we can get this to work. Yeah, it's coming in a little too thick sometimes. But yeah, all in all, it's still looking pretty good. I think ultimately I'm going to be happy with this figure. It's hard to get all the angles in right. Because you want that leg to get just the right amount of circuitry in there. Yeah, it's a little lower than it should have been, but whatever. Okay, so far so good. This might be a very quick one, just depending on how things go. Yeah, seems to be coming along. Ah, boy. Very tricky stuff. Very tricky stuff indeed. The thing about Circuit Breaker is this silver tape that goes around her body is actually her new nervous system. She was originally paralyzed in a battle between the Autobots and Decepticons and developed this old circuits system as a new nervous system. Also gave her some flight capabilities and her ability to disrupt electronics, from what I understand. But, yeah. Or maybe she had the ability and used that to make this system. I don't remember clearly enough to really tell you for certain, but yeah. Either way, really cool concept. Really wish he was given more time to truly develop and made it to IDW. Because, you know, she worked for BlackRock in the Marvel Comics. It would have been interesting to see her relationship with BlackRock in IDW now that he's revealed to be a robot himself. So, yeah. That's an opportunity missed by unfortunate circumstances. But what bothers me is that Hasbro has the rights to Transformers and to Marvel figures. So, like, to do figures for both companies, why can't they do a Circuit Breaker in the Marvel Legends line? You know, I'm sure Marvel will be okay with it. They like making money off characters they may or may not be using actively. And they are not actively using Circuit Breaker because of her connection to Transformers. I mean, even if Marvel did find a way to use her, I'd be happy with that, you know. Just make use of the character. Yeah, we're getting the feet done. Yeah, I just want to see her in action again. And I'm not a big Marvel reader, so like, normally I'm just like Sonic, Mega Man, maybe Transformers, and a little Deadpool. But lately I haven't even had the money to buy comics, so yeah, it's been a little bit of a drought on that. Although I did splurge a little lately and get the Titans Return one-shot comic, which is really cool. Definitely recommend it to any Transformers fan, because it is good. Yeah, there we go. That's coming along nice. Now we gotta worry about the back because, yeah, it is very sad and depressing to see it so bare. I do want one line right down her spinal cord. Right down her spine. Kind of really bring home the fact that this is her new spinal cord. Oop. Careful. So, yeah, let's see if we can get some design here. Go, get that going. And there we go, that's a nice looking back piece. Just want to trying to make it look like it's connected to each other on the legs. Yeah, there we go. So that's actually looking pretty nice. Yeah, I think I'm happy with that for now. So I guess it's time we got back to that head. I'm just starting off with this one here that we've been working with. Got to get the paint off the needle, because I'm going to be working more with the eyes, adding some actual irises. And I'm going to make her give her blue eyes, just because I can. Of course, the cap would be, well, was kind of locked in. You know how these paint things just kind of fuse, and that paint is bad. So I gotta find another bit of blue paint. And try not to step on wires that I need. So, let's see. Luckily, I'm not really short on blue paint, so. Okay, this one's sealed up pretty bad, so. Here. Yeah. This is stuff you use to strengthen the bond between your ground and items on it, but can also help with this. There we go. Sorry about that, folks. Just took a little more muscle than I thought it would need. But yeah. Now, the eyes are very tricky. Especially when you're trying to make sure you don't give them derp eyes. Because you can only put down just a teeny drop. And yeah, giving them derp eyes is a lot easier than you think it is. So, really why you need to be careful. Fortunately, I can't get the paint to just drop where I want it to. This is very difficult stuff. I'm gonna try a toothpick for this. So let's just try to gently dab on the blue there. There. And yeah, that kind of looks creepy. Unfortunately, this is the hard part. I don't think I did a good job on these. It's not horrible, but yeah, you can tell it's not, they're not derp eyes at least, but yeah, they're not the best eyes either. So next up, probably shouldn't have bothered putting this in the terpenoid, but we're gonna do the circuit pattern on Circuit Breaker's face. Which shouldn't be too difficult. Some of it's going to be covered up by the hair the way it is, but it's fine. It's kind of, where is it? Around her eye. It's a very interesting, somewhat intricate design. I'm getting a little shaky here too. And I'm doing this before the hair for a reason, because I'm worried that the hair will actually go right over it. So this one, it goes right from the cheek down. Into the chin. Okay, so something like that. And actually, there's a little bit along the nose. So something like that. And that does it for the circuit pattern on this particular one. Gonna get a little, go back to the body, make sure it goes all the way up the neck. Just want it to go all the way up the neck, make sure it gets in there nice and tight. And now we actually have the hair to contend with. So, I'm gonna get some hair, get some yellow, gonna get, because she's pretty much like a blonde, orangish hair. And the yellow will do, and we can use a translucent orange for a wash. And for this, we're actually gonna use that, like a, more of a brush type brush. One like this. This might actually be a bit big for it. Do I have anything? This will do. Yeah, here we go. This will be better. And yeah, we'll just paint the hair. This is actually going to be kind of tricky. All things considered. Yeah, we'll just use the ball joint to keep a grip on it. Paint the hair in. I do be real careful about this, though. Get out of the way. Just let the sculpt be the guide. This case. And it's coming along nicely. I mean, the hair isn't that hard to do. At least in this case. And the hardest part is actually just avoiding going off the hair and into the skin. Which seems to be going pretty, all things considered, it's going smooth. Mm-hmm. And yeah, her head's actually looking pretty good. Again, probably the eyes aren't the best, but I think they turned out well enough. Okay, gotta give that a little time to dry. Just gonna set this down here. Hopefully, it won't smear anything. But yeah, that takes care of that part. And for the base, you know, we're actually pretty much done. But, you know, if you wanted a barefoot circuit breaker, perhaps, right, we can do something with that. Because, you know, this one gives you a lot of extra parts and extra options. Some are pretty straightforward, some are actually fairly cool. So why don't we work at those a bit? Especially since we gotta wait for that hair to dry before we do the wash on it, so yeah. Well, in this case, it's going to be pretty simple stuff. Let's do a little tape pattern on there. You know, just a little bit at the bottom of the foot. And a little touch at the heel. And that's just one. So yeah, I'm just trying to make some options for my circuit breaker, you know. Nothing severe, but just enough options that I can actually enjoy the figure a little more. Because, yeah, these feet are very intricate. I mean, you got all the toes made out. I mean, I don't have the skill to actually try to paint all those toes, but it's pretty cool that they actually went through all that effort. May as well try to make the most of it. And of course we got the sandaled feet. This I could probably just try to dry brush the laces. And you'd think this would be easier, but it's not necessarily the case. Because you gotta do it just gently enough that you get the laces and not the actual feet. And you kinda gotta have very little paint on the actual brush. Oh yeah, this can be a little trickier than one would expect. But if you're willing to work at it, it will pan out very nicely. Because, yeah, that's actually looking pretty good. Oh dear, this is kind of long. Probably should try doing a Twitch stream or something for the next one I do. Which I think if I can secure a second siren and the right faceplate, I might try Nerva. At least a Titan Master for Minerva. May do a full-on Minerva if I can get a hold of an extra breakaway, or getaway, whatever you want to call him. Because he looks like he'd be the ideal subject for that. This one. This one I'm kind of screwing up already. I'm actually getting paint on the feet instead of just the laces. Which is not good. Not good at all. But I was excited about Titan's return. They were getting a six shot. Japan's actually really going all out for Jinrai, which is good. Kind of want to get that version. And I do want to get the US version as well. It's just going to be hard. I mean, as good as Hasbro's been doing with these, and yeah, I think they've been doing pretty good with it. Takara's just killing it. You know. The right colors for Galvatron. They actually painted the head, which is nice. Although, in any case, there is a dude on Shapeways who actually made replacement heads for Galvatron, so you don't have to use the Titan Master at all if you don't want to. Which is pretty cool. I'm going to actually check on that. Head for Circuit Breaker. And get my wash ready, wash paint ready. So yeah, the head's looking pretty good so far. We're gonna add a little something to help the hair stick out just a bit more. And yeah, I got these on wax paper, which will be good for not smearing paint on them. Because the wax won't stick, unlike my fingers, which will stick very much to the paint. But yeah, I'm using Tamiya color, acrylic orange, like translucent orange. I just want to lightly brush over this with it, which will go from being a blonde to a bit of a redhead, but the blonde highlights will be there. It's actually a nice way to boost up the color a bit. Just get a nice base, go with the translucent color. And if I want the blonde to come out again, I could always just dry brush over the orange. Yeah, there we go. That's actually looking pretty good. Adds a little color. Makes it look nice. No, I gotta let that dry just a little bit before I actually try to put it on. Gotta figure out where that needle went to. Of course, on second thought, I might just try this with a toothpick. I've had better luck. Because I got another head. We got the ponytail head. I want to at least make this one. You know, because I do like long-haired girls. That's a personal thing, but you know. It is what it is. Let's just try to. Unfortunately, this is going horribly wrong. Boy. Let's see if I can get that out. Okay. Seems like it is coming out for the most part, which is good. Let's see. This is still got orange on it. Yeah, I just want to get the eye right. When these really small openings, it's hard. Especially with white paint's nature. I'm sure anybody who's painted knows how much of a pain white paint can be to work with. I'm sorry my hands are covering everything, but talking about something that's delicate. Doesn't really help that my hands aren't very steady. Seems like there's a hair. There we go. That takes care of that part. There we go. I guess that'll have to do for the eyes. I'm probably driving someone crazy right now because, for the most part, she's just about done. She's probably done enough. Okay, well, before we do any added stuff, let's at least get a look at the highlight here. Actually, we can go to the other camera, which is probably better suited for this. As you can see, she turned out fairly nice. And I do like it. And front and back. Looks pretty good. Face isn't bad. Yeah, I think she turned out fairly well. Yeah. I'll probably work at the other heads a little later. But for now, I think I'm going to call this one done, at least as far as the overall custom goes. I mean, at least the basic part. We'll get the alternate stuff done privately. So I thought we'd finish this off by actually taking a look at Circuit Breaker all finished up. And as you can see, the paint job went pretty well. All things considered, it went quite nicely. Close up in. And as you can see, I got the bare feet on her right now with a little bit of silver paint on them. And yeah, the silver circuit pattern went okay, not the straightest. I'll never claim to have the steadiest hand, but it turned out pretty well. And yeah, the face turned out alright. Quite possibly could have gone better. Oops. Get this in frame. But all in all, it did turn out well. The eyes are Yeah, a little bit odd, unfortunately. They're really, really tiny, so it's hard to get a good paint set up in them. So, yeah, before you complain about dirt buys, try to realize this is very hard to do. Turning around, the hair turned out pretty good. I like how the dual colors actually created that difference and really brought out the hair texture. So that orange wash really did some wonders. But she does have another head, which I like. Out of the four heads she painted, came with, I painted two. So, yeah. So we'll take off the short hair head, and we'll put on soon. I can get it on there. The ponytail head. And it completely got out of frame. Okay, there we go. Sorry about that. And yeah, had a little bit of a paint splotch there with the orange. And the eyes could have turned out better, unfortunately. Again, really tiny eyes. But the hair did turn out pretty good. So yeah, the short hair face came out better, but both of them turned out okay. So, guess we should take a look at the back as well. Because, you know, just in case. So yeah, circuit pattern came out okay along the back. We'll just lift the hair up. I had to wing it for this one because there weren't too many good looks at how that circuit pattern went in the backside. I did go for a little bit more around the butt, but you know, that's just, I think I saw something where it showed it like a full bottom, so that was something I had to do. So, and it turned out well. All in all, I'm quite happy with this. So, yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this look at the boss fight, blank female body, this customization into Circuit Breaker. Please leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe, let me know what you think, and I'll see you next time. So until then, goodbye out there, whatever you are.